Hi students, this is Viswanath, chemistry faculty for NEET and IIT exams. This year IIT mains exam pattern, just I am revising. In this three subjects are there, total 300 marks exam, maths 100 marks, physics 100 marks, chemistry 100 marks. Regarding to chemistry, I am telling two types of questions are there, 20 multiple choice questions and 10 numerical type based questions. In these 20 questions, each question carries 4 marks. So, 20 into 4, 80 marks. All the 20 questions we should attempt. These are single answer type questions and they have negative marking also. Come to the another type of questions. 10 questions, numerical type questions. In this, 5 questions are choice. That means from these 10, students have to attempt only 5. Each question carries 4 marks, 5 into 4, 20 marks. In this, no negative marking. So, total 80 plus 20. 80 plus 20, that is equal to 100 marks. Now, till now, we completed 18 questions. In that, multiple choice questions. Now, see the numerical value type questions. First one is, how many amines are formed by Gabriel thalamide reaction? 4 amines are given. In this, how many compounds we can prepare by using this Gabriel thalamide reaction? For this very simple answer, we no need of writing equation to prepare these amines. For this answer is, this Gabriel thalamide reaction is suitable for the preparation of aliphatic primary amines. Aliphatic primary amines can be prepared by using this Gabriel thalamide method, Gabriel thalamide reaction. Find out the aliphatic primary amines in the given compounds. This is not aliphatic amine. This is an aliphatic amine. Isobutyl group attached to NH2. So it is an aliphatic primary amine. Only one carbon atom attached to nitrogen in NH2 group. So it is an aliphatic primary amine. In this also C6H5CH2. Only one carbon attached to the nitrogen of the amine. It is also aliphatic primary amine. And this one C6H5CH3. Aryl group, methyl group attached to the nitrogen. It is a secondary amine. So, we can prepare this compound and this compound by using Gabriel thalamide reaction. So, how many amines we can prepare means, answer, 2 amines. So, 2 amines we can prepare. Next, see the next one. For the following combustion reaction, C6HY plus MO2 gives rise to NCO2 plus PH2O. Oxygen required 6 times the volume of hydrocarbon and CO2 produced is 4 times the volume of hydrocarbon. What will be the value of Y? So this Y value we should find out. Understand given information carefully. Oxygen required 6 times the volume of hydrocarbon. Here, this is hydrocarbon, general representation. Now, 6 times the volume of oxygen compared to volume of this. That means, suppose hydrocarbon volume is 1 volume, this oxygen required 6 volumes. So, we can write 6O2. Gives rise to, what about carbon dioxide produced is 4 times the volume of hydrocarbon. So 4CO2 plus H2O. Now reactant side, how much amount of oxygen? 6 into 2, 12 atoms. Here 4 into 2, 8. How many oxygen atoms are required? 4. So this one, reactant side, 12 oxygen atoms are there. Product side 4 into 2, 8 plus 4, 12 oxygen atoms balanced. Now come to the hydrocarbon formula. How many carbon atoms? 4. So C4. Product side, how many hydrogens? 4 into 2, 8. So final equation is C4H8 plus 6O2 gives rise to 4CO2 plus 4H2O. Now what is the value of Y? That equal to 8. This value we want, so Y equal to 8. Next, 10 grams acetylene at pressure 740 mm of Hg and 25 degrees Celsius temperature occupy volume in liters is. It's very simple numerical related to ideal gas equation. What is ideal gas equation? PV equal to nRT. PV equal to nRT. From this we want volume. V equal to nRT by P. So n means number of moles. Is it given? No. Here gas is acetylene. Its weight is given 10 grams. We want number of moles. Given mass of acetylene divided by molar mass of acetylene. Given mass 10 into R value 0.082 into temperature 25 degrees Celsius in Kelvin 298. Here number of moles means mass by molar mass. What is molar mass of acetylene? See this C2H2, 2 into 12 plus 1 into 2, 24 plus 2, that equal to 26. So 26 into pressure. In the question they gave 740 mm of Hg, convert that into atmosphere. Then we have to divide this value with 760. 760, 740 divided by 760. Then final volume is, after doing calculation we can get 9.65 liters. So approximate value 10 liters. Then what is the answer? 10 liters is the answer. Next, say this next one. The solubility of PbI2 lead iodide in 0.1 molar PbNO3 twice lead nitrate solution is x into 10 power minus 2. So in this solution its solubility is x into 10 power minus 2. Then value of x is given Ksp of PbI2. Solubility product of lead iodide equal to 8 into 10 power minus 9. Now we want to find out x value. Okay, write down this. PbNO3 twice lead nitrate. PbNO3 twice gives rise to Pb2 plus 2NO3 minus. What is the concentration of PbNO3 in the given question? 0.1 molar. So here also 1 mole of lead ions. So concentration 0.1 molar. 2 moles means 0.2 molar. Now PbI2 gives rise to Pb2 plus 2I minus. Let the solubility of this compound is S. 1 mole means S, 2 moles means 2S. But here this PbI2 is present in PbNO3 twice solution. Already lead ion concentration 0.1 molar. Now total lead ion concentration means S plus 0.1. Understood carefully? This compound is present in this solution. Because of this solution, lead ion concentration is this one. From this, some amount of lead ions are produced. Total lead ion concentration is this one. But here, solubility of this compound is very less. So, S value we can neglect. Finally, S plus 0.1 is equal to 0.1. Now KSP of PbI2 equal to solubility product of solubility of concentrations of these ions I minus whole square. So solubility of PbI2, it is given in the question, how much? 8 × 10⁻¹. 8 × 10⁻¹, this one. 8 × 10⁻¹, that equal to lead ion concentration 0.1. 0.1 into 2s whole square. From this we can write, see here, 8 × 10⁻¹, that equal to 4s square. This 0.1 we can write 1/10. It goes to left hand side, we can get this value. From this, s square equal to 2 × 10⁻¹. That implies s equal to square root of 2 × 10⁻¹. Finally, s equal to root 2 means 4.414 × 10⁻¹. So s value 1.414 × 10⁻¹. Next, how many of the following compounds are paramagnetic in nature? Alpha sulfur, beta sulfur and S2. See this here, in S2 molecule in gaseous state, two unpaired electrons are there. Two unpaired electrons are present. That's why it shows paramagnetic nature. It is, this point is given in the NCERT textbook in P block elements. Thank you, students.